Hi friends, today I'm going to discuss about primary amenorrhea. Menorrhea means menses and A is absence of menses. There are two criteria to describe them. In absence of secondary sexual characters, that is no breast growth or no pubic hair or axillary hair growth, no menses till 14 years of age. In absence of secondary sexual characters, no menses till 14 years of age. And if these secondary sexual characters are present and the patient is not getting menses till 16 years of age. In presence of secondary sexual characters, no menses till 16 years of age. These both comes under primary amenorrhea. Coming to the most common cause is Turner syndrome. Karyotype is 45X0. Second most common thing is Mullerian agensis. Third most common is testicular feminizing syndrome. All these have alternative names for them. Turner syndrome is also called as ovarian dysgenesis. Mullerian agensis is also called as Rokitansky-Mayer-Kushner-Hauser syndrome. Rokitansky-Mayer-Kushner-Hauser syndrome. And the third one is androgen insensitivity syndrome. Coming to ovaries, there is ovarian dysgenesis. Ovaries are absent in Turner's syndrome, but uterus is present. In second one, Mullerian agensis, ovaries are present, but no uterus. In third one, ovaries are absent, testes are present in this patients. Uterus is also absent. As the name suggests, testicular feminizing syndrome. There will be testes present. Mullerian uterus and fallopian tubes come from Mullerian ducts. Hence, Mullerian agensis, no uterus will be present. Coming to the karyotypes of all these causes for primary amenorrhea, 46XS is Mullerian agensis, 46XY is testicular feminizing syndrome, and 45X0 is Turner's syndrome. You have to remember these karyotypes. For Mullerian agensis patient, it is also associated with renal and skeletal abnormalities. Deafness is also associated with these patients. Coming to testicular feminizing syndrome, these are mentally normal and there are no associated anomalies. Reproduction is possible in Mullerian agensis because ovaries are present, but uterus is absent. For this, surrogacy can be taken. Through surrogacy, they can have their own biological child. In testicular feminizing syndrome, there will be no ovaries, no uterus. Hence, reproduction is not possible. This is the thing you have to remember about testicular feminizing syndrome. All these are things about this. Reproduction is also not possible in Turner's syndrome. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe.